very frequently asked a question, a very common question asked in solenoid, why just outside the magnetic field is zero? But note, if you are at a considerable distance away from a solenoid, suppose you are at a position here, and this is a solenoid, and suppose you are a position here, the field is not zero, but very near to the solenoid, the magnetic field is zero. So here you have seen half of a solenoid is drawn, and obviously magnetic lines of force is going inside the solenoid. So this has to be south pole and this has to be north pole, as we have done in earlier video. And what I told you while doing the finding the magnetic field inside the solenoid, what I told you, ki just inside the outside the solenoid is zero. Suppose this is a turn and this is another turn, and here current is coming out. This is wire, this is the wire, this is a single wire, this is a wire, and half of the solenoid is above the paper and half of the solenoid is below the paper, which is not seen here. And this is half of the turn, half of the turn is shown here and half of the turn is below the paper. So if you consider any two consecutive turn, suppose turn number this and turn number this, second and third turn if you consider. So at this point current is coming out like here, this, right? At these two points here current is coming out like this. Here again current is coming out, here also current is coming out, and it is going inside, it is going inside, here it is going inside. Clear? So if we take those two consecutive turns, it looks like this. Here it is a turn coming out, half turn like this, it is coming out and going down here, turn. Second turn is coming out from here and going down here. Well, so this way it is coming out and going down, this way another turn coming out and going down. So if you consider this small portion of, so you can consider that a small wire, conducting wire is here, where current is in upward direction, where current is in upward direction. Here also current is in upward direction, and here current is in downward direction. Here current is going downward, here current going downward. Now let us consider, if current is coming upward from right hand thumb rule, the magnetic lines of force will be like this. Magnetic lines of force. And for this and for upward current, if you use thumb rule, you will see that magnetic lines of force are like this. And for this turn also, if you use right hand thumb rule, we will see that magnetic lines of force are like this. It is also clockwise, right hand thumb rule. Now just outside this solenoid, what you are seeing here, the one lines of force coming in this direction and other was coming in from this direction. One is coming from this direction and other one is coming from this direction, this direction. So one is coming here this way and other one is coming from this way, and they will cancel each other of equal magnitude. So just near the solenoid, just near the solenoid here, just near the solenoid, the magnetic field is zero. But if you go at a considerable amount distance here, suppose you consider, here you will see that magnetic lines of force for this this wire is also in this direction, and for this wire is also in this direction. And in a net effect of this lines of force, two lines of force will be like this, and they don't cancel each other, they act in the same direction. Act in a same direction here also. But just near the solenoid, just outside the solenoid, one is coming in this way, another one is coming is this way, and they are equal and opposite to each other. So these two vector quantities cancel each other. That is why, if you were asked ki why we consider that two, why we consider that magnetic lines of force or magnetic field just outside the solenoid is zero. So for that you can answer this. You have to draw the figure, and you can explain this way. It is just outside the solenoid. Two magnetic lines of force are just opposite to each other, and they cancel each other. But if you go at a certain distance, considerable amount of distance, you will find that they do not cancel each other because they act in the same direction. Okay. So in earlier video, what I told you, ki when we draw ampere loop, and the loop which was just outside the solenoid, the loop which was just outside the solenoid, here we considered B is equal to 0. What we have considered, B is equal to, in last video we have considered B is equal to 0. Clear? So B is 0 because we have taken CD very near to the solenoid. And as all we know, ki we are free to choose any kind of Amperian loop for according to our convenience. So we take CD which is very near to the solenoid, so that B is 0 here. That is why this Amperian loop we consider, where length AB is passes through the center of the solenoid, that is from the axis of the solenoid, and side CD of the rectangle which is which is very near to the solenoid. And we have the liberty to choose my shape, size, position of my loop, and we consider it according to our convenience. And since CD, if we consider CD very near to the solenoid, it was convenient to us. We need not require to calculate B here. That is why you have considered CD very near to the solenoid, and this we have the liberty to do so. That is why we have considered CD very near to the solenoid, whereas AB we take passing through the center of the solenoid. That is why we considered in earlier video the magnetic field along the CD is 0, because CD length was taken very near to the solenoid.